get started because I don't want to hold you all back because I'm sure you have other stuff to do as well. All right. So welcome to the call. I wanted to do Ashley actually messaged me and she asked if we wanted to do a power hour, and I was all about it because that was actually what I had planned to do also, just because we're getting at the end of the month and we need to make sure we're hitting our goals for the month. Because this time is going way too fast. Like, I don't know about you all, but this month has gone super, super fast. I think it's because in the summer we think we have like time to relax, and I feel like it gets even more crazy than the kids being in school. Hi, mommy. It's crazy. But anyways, I wanted to start off because I don't know if you guys listened to the Rachel Hollis from, I don't know if you guys saw, I posted about it in Forever Fit. It was episode 101 with the mid-year check-in. Did you, any of you listen to that yet? Okay. If you haven't yet, my stupid dogs. Stacy, congratulations. if you haven't yet, I highly recommend you guys taking some time this week to listen to it. It is really, really good. And I think we all need to give ourselves that gut check with that mid-year point and what we have going on with our business. I think all of you, Stacy, I can't remember if you did. At the beginning of the year, we had goals that I had everyone fill out, and I actually printed them out and I have them. Did you fill one out, Stacy? Okay. So I have everyone's who gave it to me, and I can pull them out. If we wanted to like do a one-on-one call and look over everything, but we set these goals, and I know a lot of us set really high goals. I know for myself, I was like top 10, obviously elite in for me, because it's what I expect of myself every year, just because I have hit it before. It's just something that I want. That's important to me with like my income goals, my volume goals, and my personal goals, my fitness goals. I put all of those on my goal sheet. And now being able to look at those, it was like a huge wake up call. Like, Deidre, you're nowhere close to where you want to be for the end of the year. Now, granted, we still have like a lot of time left. We're midway. So we have another, 5 and a half months, whatever you want to call it, left. To reach those goals. But for where I am halfway, it's like nowhere close to where I really wanted to be. So it was like a good gut check to listen to that with Rachel Hollis. And she said something that I wanted to bring up to you guys and that I really liked. And she talked about making every day, acting like every day is the last day of the month or year. How often do we wait until the end of the month to reach our goals? Or how often do we wait until it's November or December to say, oh, I wanted to have this hit by the end of the year. Let's hurry up and push. I'll tell you guys, last year, me hitting elite, I don't even know how it happened, because I waited until November? And I'm like, until November, I was like, it's not going to happen for me. I'm not going to get elite. It's like out of the question. Like, my points are not even close to being there. I don't have working coaches that count, that are really doing anything. Just not enough. And then November hits, and I had a success partner that I was working with. And she was like, you can do it. And we started pushing together in November. And I'm like, I can do this. I got this in November. Like, really? So for 8 months, I was like, I can't do it. I'm not going to do it. I like talked myself out of it. And then in November and December, I worked my butt off more than I did that entire year, basically, because I pretty much got like almost half of my points in 2 months. And imagine if I put in that effort every day, or every month throughout the 12-month period that we have in that year. Now, for you guys too, same thing. Like, if you guys may set your goals at the beginning of each month, and how often do you actually work your business like you have to hit those goals and there's no other option? Or do we like to wait until the very end of the month, right? So I just really liked it, really resonated with me when she said, she was saying how we all wait until the last minute. If we acted like it was the last minute, if we gave it all we got there all the time and every day, could you imagine what goals we would be reaching? So like I said, we have 6 months, we're already halfway through the year, but like we have a whole other half. I know this first half of the year went really fast, but like we have that all over again. And it is a lot of time. Like 6 months is a lot of time. That's like a lot of days. That's like a ton of hours. Could you imagine if you just were consistently putting in the hours, even if it's a power hour a day, a full intentional power hour every single day for 6 months or even 3 months or 4 months? Like, could you imagine what we could do? So in addition to that, today I was listening to my personal development. Today was a sermon. I was listening to it on the way to eat. We went to a new restaurant tonight. And I listened to, I don't know if you guys are familiar with Elevation Worship with Stephen Furtick at all. Yes, no, maybe so. So he's out of North Carolina. I listened to him as much as I listen to my own church. And he is just incredible. I highly recommend you guys listen to him if you're looking for some personal growth, personal development, spiritual growth. But anyways, he had a guest speaker on. His name was Robert Madu. He's a pastor out of Texas. And today's sermon, what was it called? Get Over It. It was really, really good for my own personal issues because he talked a lot. He talked about being offended because I get offended a lot. So he talked about being offended. And then he mentioned, it was just random, but it was, I told my husband, I'm like, go put this in my notes section in my phone because I was driving. But he talked about being complacent and how that is going to shut doors in your life. Just staying in the same place, being complacent, and doors are just going to shut on you because you're just stuck in the same spot. There's nothing great going to come if you're not willing to move and change. But in desperation, doors will open. And he wasn't talking about Beachbody, but I was like, in other ways, I was just thinking about how that goes with my life. But one of the things was my business. And I'm like, oh, wow, that was like really good. How often do we remain complacent in our businesses? And we're just happy. We're satisfied where we are. We may not be happy where we are, but we may be satisfied where we are. And we're like, I mean, it's not going to kill me if I don't work my business today. It's not going to make or break me if I don't do it today. But then we just keep putting it off. We keep putting our business off. We struggle to get in a full power hour that is intentional every single day. And it's not really that hard. It's just creating a new habit. It's creating a habit just like everything else. But in desperation, doors will open. Have you guys ever acted like you are desperate to be successful in your business? Have you ever made it that much of a priority to make your business your priority? Not over your family, I'm not trying to say that, but just make your business a priority. Like if you come here and you're like, I want a full-time income, I want to replace my job, because I did that. I wanted to replace my job. But guys, when I did that, I acted desperate with my business. I put in a power hour every single day. I don't think there was a day I missed the first 2 years of my business. Like, and I made a lot of sacrifices. Yes, I made sacrifices away from my family, but guys, I was desperate to make this business my full-time income and my only income. And at that time, my ex-husband was like, you will never quit your nursing job. And in my mind, I was like, I'm desperate to quit my nursing job. I didn't want to be there. And the only way that I could do it is if I gave no plan B. So nursing, I was like, no, I can't. I can't do nursing anymore. And now I'm like, no, there's no plan B. I can't go back to nursing. So yes, you have to act desperate for this job and make it your only plan, your only plan A, no plan B. And your business is it's gonna flourish. You're gonna be successful. But if you remain complacent in your business and you act like there's another option, if you're like, yeah, I can go back to nursing, or yeah, I don't have to quit my job. It's there for me. It's my safe zone. Guess what, guys? If you keep your other option in the back of your head, it's going to always stay there. It's going to be there, but your business isn't going to change. So I just want to challenge you guys for the last 6 months, 5 months, however many months, July, August, September, October, November. Okay. Yeah. 6 months. I think, yeah. If you act like there's no other option and just make it your priority, make this your only plan and it just give no other option, you will do so many things in 2019. You may be like, I haven't done anything in 2019, but you have no idea what can change in 6 months. Like a lot, a lot, a lot. Think about the most successful month you've had in your business and imagine if you did that all the time. It's crazy what we can really do if we put our minds to it and just make it our priority. So act desperate. Make this like your desperation, okay? Now, let's do a power hour. I just wanted to say that because it was that Rachel Hollis. I've listened to it twice now because it was just that good. And then hearing that sermon today, I'm like, huh, it was just really good, wasn't it? I liked it. I liked what I said. All right. So we are going to do a power hour. Ashley, did you have any certain steps, anything you wanted to do differently with the power hour tonight? I know you like to sometimes come up with new ideas. So I don't have any new ideas other than what I just said.
No, the only thing I wanted to touch on tonight was like, I know that the struggle right now is like, how do I get people to sign up now and not wait until Morning Meltdown 100 comes out on July 1st or July 16th. So my power hour and communication stuff is primarily coming from follow-ups right now. People that I've talked to previously, and just people that have given me price objections. So a lot of those conversations that I'm having with people are like, it's not going to be any more reasonable right now. And you're going to get thousands of opportunities to try different workouts. Like, you know, just everything that they get. Same thing with the Ultimate Portion Fix stuff, like going back to those people and just letting them know that like they can get all the things for a lot cheaper this month. So I don't know where everybody's at on that, but the conversations I've been having this last week with people that are potentially interested are, you know, I hate to say like, don't sign up now, but I also feel like the more upfront I am with what's coming out next month, like to give them the opportunity, but also to let them know, like you're saving an extra $20 this month by signing up before the end of the month and offering incentives and stuff like that. So like I have a girl that I need to send a link to tonight and we talked about the Morning Meltdown and I had her try the workout and I said, tell me what you think about this. Is this something that you think you want to do? Do you want to wait? And also just telling them they can't purchase it until July 16th unless they sign up as a coach. And she was like, I don't want to sign up as a coach. I need workouts now. Sign me up today. So that has been a little bit helpful, just having that like upfront conversation with them. And then going to a lot of those people that are interested in Morning Meltdown and saying, listen, like you can get started now and then you can sign up next month for these workouts at a discount or whatever. So that way, if they want to start early, they can. Anyway, that was kind of all I had.
Yeah, that was good. You haven't seen me post a lot about MM100. Now I did yesterday and I did put it in my stories just to get it out there, but I don't want to do it too much until I'm done with reaching my goals for this month because I am still at SC8 and I need to be at least 10. My goal is like double that, but whatever. We won't talk about that, but I don't want to promote that until I'm at my goals. Because I don't want to say hold off and just wait. There are people. So what I'm doing, and Ashley's probably doing the same thing too, is follow-ups. Like follow up with everyone because $20 off the challenge pack is going to change people's minds. Like that person who said, I don't have the finances right now, is going to go for that $20 off. Like that will be big to somebody else who didn't have the finances or gave the cost objection before. So I will go back to all of those people, and I hope that you're writing them down so you can go back and say, hey, so-and-so, I'll show you whenever we do our follow-ups, but, you know, talking to them and saying that I know you're interested in the past, and I know that at the time you didn't have the finances, but I wanted to keep you in mind, keep you in the loop of our sale, because it is going to end here at the end of the month, and I just wanted to give you an opportunity. You will have access to my boot camp. I would love to have you in. We have a great group of ladies. So that's what I say to people, and I'm just follow up with everyone. So that's how I got myself to 0 to 8 in the last 4 days. So let's keep it going. All right. So guys, I'm like not on it today. If you guys all did a post, good for you, because I didn't. Sorry, I'm not leading by example, but Ashley looks really cute. She just popped up in my newsfeed.
I did not do a post yet today either. Like,
You just did it 30 minutes ago.
Well, I did like a Taco Tuesday post, but I didn't do like a call to action post. And I'm planning on doing that tonight. I get a lot of traction when I do my posts at like 11 p.m., and then everybody sees them first thing in the morning, and then that's my like fresh start for the day.
Yep.
And then my kids are finally in bed, so I feel like my brain can work like when my kids are not around. It's like, mom.
All right. So if you guys haven't done a post yet, do the post after our call. Oh my gosh, my dogs. Is today Tuesday? Yes, Transformation Tuesday. Some kind of, whether it's, it could be about your fitness journey. I feel like at the end of the month, if you're not at your goals yet, talk about your fitness journey and sign someone up with a challenge pack of some sort. Rather than, I know we talk about coaching towards the last half of the month, but if you're not at your goals yet, challenge groups. Just talk about your challenge groups and get someone signed up so you can help them on their fitness journey, and then they'll turn into a working coach. All right, let's take 5 minutes and no, 3 minutes and do some birthdays, okay? We should be able to do that within 3 minutes. All right, and go.
I will add, this girl that I'm signing up right now is, she wanted to do the payment plan for on demand and order some samples of the performance line. And I was like, okay, well, this is what that's going to cost you. And I like broke down the whole cost of what she's going to pay like over the course of, you know, the year or whatever. And she was like, oh, well, that's dumb. Just do the challenge pack. And so sometimes that like makes a big difference for them to like, I was like, well, the performance line is going to cost this and this and this, and then you're on demand. And she's like, oh, well, yeah, no, I don't want to do that. So instead I'm just sending her samples of stuff that I have in addition to her challenge pack, and just explain to her that like 30-day money back guarantee, you can swap it out. If you don't like the flavor, they'll send you a different flavor. And she was pretty happy with that.
That's good. All right, did you guys get yours done? I can't see anyone, sorry. Some days I don't have a lot of birthdays, and other days I have like a ton. All right. So next, let's do some connections. Let's do 10 minutes of connections. Anyone who you just, I would go with whoever's online. Talk to new people. If you see someone on your, if you're on your computer, anyone who has that green button on the side with a list of names, just go to their profile, go to their Facebook page, and comment, like, on something, and then send them a message. And just say, hey, how's going? Don't do anything Beachbody related. Just make connections with them.
Where you been? when I'm underneath the bright lights, when I'm trying to have a good time, cause I'm good now, you ain't mine, nah, 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 don't call me up, when you're looking at my photos, getting hot, losing control, you want me more, now I let go, nah, 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 I'm over you, and I don't need your lies no more, cause the truth is that you're going stronger, and I know you said that I'd change my cold heart. Don't call me up, I'm going out tonight. Feeling good now, you're out of my life. Don't wanna talk about us, gotta leave it behind. One drink and you're out of my mind. I'm not to get out of. Baby, I'm on the high, you're alone, going out of your mind. But I'm here, I'm in the club, and I don't wanna talk. So don't call me up, cause I'm here looking fine, babe. And I got eyes looking my way, and then I'm on my vibe, babe.
I want you to hold me down.
All right, guys, timer is up. Sorry, I'm just finishing this last one. Okay. All right. How many connections did you guys get in? Put it in the chat bar. Good deal. I see a Charlie. Okay,
hi.
Hi. What are you doing?
Sitting on mommy's counter.
Yeah.
All right, we're gonna work, Charlie. Tell Victor bye.
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 All right, guys. So let's go ahead and do some invites. We're gonna take, let's take 15 minutes to do that. Whether you wanna do it from your Facebook or Instagram, go off of your posts that you've been doing. And this is a good way to send an invite saying that you are getting ready to launch a new test group with a new program, if that's what you want to do. If you're not at your goals yet, let's stick with the, hey, maybe they've been interested in the past, or maybe you see that they're talking about their fitness journey, or maybe they're posting a recipe. I love getting the people who just talk about food on their Facebook pages, because I'm like, hey, I would love to help you if you are working on your fitness journey. I saw that you were posting recipe. I would love to have you into my boot camp where we focus on food. Exercise is optional. I like to promote the 2B mindset. That's just me. And I love that program and I've had a lot of success with it. So I will talk about that and say that we have a sale promo going on and would love to give them more information. So go ahead and let's take some time. I just started the timer. Let's take some time to send out some invites, and I will share with you what I am saying. Thank you.
lover, I'd never lie. Still be true, I swear I'll try. In the end, it's only night. Got his head, I'm on my mind. Got that love, crazy kind. I am his, and he is mine. In the end, it's him and I.
I'm 65, spinning up the PCH, a hell of a ride. Don't wanna see us make it, they just wanna divide. 2017, Bonnie and Clyde. Wouldn't see the point of living on if one of us died. Yeah. Got that kind of style, everybody try to rip off. Why it sells dress under when she take the mink off. Silk on her body, pull it down and watch her slip off. Every time she cheated, she would try to come up. Crazy, but I love her, I can never run from her. It is no rubber, never would have been such a. She don't talk about the man, she be so stubborn. No pain, no suffer.
Remember the words you told me to learn so the day I die. Surrender everything cause you made me believe you're mine. Say do you call me baby and now you're calling me my name. Takes one to know one, yeah, you beat me at my own damn game. Pushing you, pushing, I'm pulling away from you. I give it, I give it, I'm giving you take, giving you take. Your flow, see you want me, see you want me. Body and that, and I'm just a dead man walking out. But you need it, yeah, you need it. All of this time. Young man, see you want me, see you want me. That is the last.
All right, sorry. I just posted my invite there. Hey, does anyone have an image of like challenge pack options that you send to people? Like what's included in a challenge pack with like pricing on it?
So I have like in my email that I do, I have my BOD challenge packs. And that shows what's included, but those are the only ones. I just saved the To Be Mindset because I'm gonna put that in a different email. Do you want like all of the images, or?
One of my coaches was like, "What do you send people?" And I'm like, "I usually don't. Like, I don't usually send an image unless it's like I have To Be Mindset stuff, and then yeah. I have Meltdown stuff, and I have like Lift 4 stuff, but I don't have like just a general."
So Stacy said I have the email with Jen Guthrie with her pack, those packages. That's what I use. So it's the BOD packages. But if I have someone with To Be Mindset, though, I don't show that. I just tell them what's in it, and then I set them up with a share card.
Oh, okay. Will you send me that, Stacy, what you have, or if you have it right there?
I have it in the team page, too.
Oh, do you?
Yeah, it's under... I'll tag you in it.
Okay.
And it also should be in the Dream Team page.
Oh, I bet I do have that saved in my Google Docs.
Because she's done it twice recently.
Uh-huh. Let me look at my Google Docs. I bet I do have something in there. I just never send like an actual image.
I have it under script here. I'm tagging you in it now.
Okay. just in case. But I'm switching out some of the wording, and I'm doing a to be mindset one also. I just haven't finished it.
I don't have it. That's so weird. I don't know where it went.
You don't have that one?
I don't have it saved in my Google Docs. I thought I did because
I'm
Okay, I got one girl signed up and I'm working on another one.
Yay, get it, girl.
Yes.
So that'll make you a SC12.
So that, yeah, that one would put me at 12. And this one, do you remember Kelly Archer?
Yes.
Yeah, she's wants to sign back up.
Nice.
Not, I don't know that she wants to sign up as a coach, but she wants to get back into stuff. So trying to get her tonight. And then I got another girl who just did a coach change because she wants to join my group. And I'm going to try to get her signed up with. She might want to do Morning Meltdown because we talked a little about that. So I'll see. But I got to run. I got to put my kids to bed before 8:30. I just realized it's 8:25.
It sure is.
So I'm going to hop off.
Well, glad that you jumped on. Thank you.
Yeah, get it, girls. Have a good night.
You too. See ya.
Bye.
All right, guys. We have less than 2 minutes left, so let's keep it going. All right. All right, so now let's do some follow-ups. Let's do it for 15 minutes because these are what we really need to be working on. I'll be showing you guys what I am saying with my follow-ups as well. Started off right, I can see it in your eyes. I can tell that you won't be more. Been on your mind, there's no reason we should hide. Tell me something I ain't heard before. Oh, I've been dreaming about it, and it's you I'm on. So stop thinking about it. Can we just talk? Can we just talk about how we're doing before we get lost? Let me know how we know it's not one. Never felt like it before. I only tried to pull too far. Can we just talk? Can we just talk about how we're doing? Got some flowers in the room. Make sure I leave the door unlocked. Now I'm on the way. Catch.
So this is my follow-up.
It wasn't so damn hard to be, but every
Does anyone know how long we spent? Because I never put the time on. I just went to see how much time we had left. I'm like, I feel like we should be done soon. Never. I never press start. All right. Well, I'm going to give us 5 more minutes because we need to do as many follow-ups as possible. Okay. 5 more minutes and then we'll call it a night. Can you guys hear my awesome music and what do you think about it? Does anyone want to dance? I hated this song like yesterday. Do you know this song? It's so weird. This is a Billy person. My stepson introduced me to it.
And it's so weird, but I'm actually kind of liking it a little bit. But I didn't like it yesterday. I think it's one of those that it like grows on you.
I'm pretty glad that you're alone. He said she's here. I mean, I don't see what she's seeing, but maybe it's because I'm wearing you alone. Cause I know that I failed you. I should have done you better. Cause you don't want to lie. I know she gives you everything, but I couldn't give it to you. I know that you got everything, but I got nothing to give without you.
Did you guys get a good bit done? Get some follow-ups in? Good.
Misty's still working hard over there.
Oh, I'm so tired, guys.
I've done not near enough lately, so I used this hour to, like, work.
Hey, that's what it's there for. I'm glad that you took advantage.
I did. I, like, was in the zone.
That's good. Okay. I'm going to do a power hour in the morning.
What time?
So my goal every day is 5:30, but 5:30 is for me to get my devotions in and my journaling and Bible reading. So from 5:30 to 6, that's my time. I've only done it once this week. No, that was last week. This is Tuesday. I haven't done it yet this week. So I'm gonna say 5:30 again for me to do that. So 6 o'clock.
Okay, text me. I wanna get up and work out, but I have to leave my house by 8:45. So if we're gonna do it, we really have to do it at like 6. So
okay. 6 o'clock. I'm gonna post it in the team page.
Okay.
Who knows who will jump on? If you guys want to do it, I'm going to do it at 6 o'clock. I'm really scared.
If more people do it, it would be more accountability for us to get up and do it.
Right. That's why I'm saying it. I'm like, oh, crap. Now I really got to do it. All right. 6 o'clock. I'm posting it. We'll do it. All right. Good deal.